So you're probably already using reminders for lots of things on your Mac. But here are some helpful tips to help you get more out of it. For instance, when you create a new reminder, you don't have to set the time separately. For instance, if I were to create one called meeting, I can click the I button here, click on a day, and then set a specific date and time. But I could also do this. I could hit the plus button and then I could just simply type with regular language and give it a time, like meeting tomorrow at 3 p.m. Notice how it converts it to meeting and the time is set, tomorrow 3 p.m. I can look at the information and see that that is exactly what's set. Now if you have scheduled things in several reminders lists, it might be useful to actually see all of them together. You can click the scheduled item here on the left. It only appears if you have some scheduled events. And here you can see I've got three different things scheduled and they're obviously coming from different reminders lists, so it's nice to be able to see them all together. In addition, you've got this candy calendar down here on the bottom left. You can turn that on or off with view, show, and hide calendar, and you can jump to any date here to see just the items that are due that day. You can see these little dots underneath the calendar, dates that have events and reminder scheduled for that day. So for instance, for today I've got none, so there's no dot there. But tomorrow there's two, so there's a dot under it. You can also set priorities for reminders. So going back into here, we can click on I here, and in addition to the on a day for setting a time, we can also set a priority. So you can do low, medium, high, or none. Once you've set a priority for something, so let's set that one to high, you'll see it's got a symbol next to it, in this case three exclamation points for the highest one. And then I can sort by those. So I can go to View, Sort By, and I can sort by priority. So I can always put the higher priority ones at the top. And I can go back to Manual Sorting. Manual Sorting allows me to actually drag and drop these items. It's best to grab just to the left of the circle. And I could drag them to any order I want. I can sort by something like the title, and it will sort them. And if I go and sort by manual, it remembers the order that I move them to. Now in addition to viewing scheduled items, I can also view completed ones. It may not be obvious how to do this at first, but if you are to drag down with two fingers on the trackpad or one on a magic mouse, you can reveal an item above the top item here. And it says, for instance, five are completed from this list, and I can hit show to show the completed items. The same thing for scheduled. I can show all the completed scheduled items. This may be very long if you completed a lot of items. There's more that you can do with a reminder than simply having a quick piece of text as the title. You can also add a note. So when I click I for information here, you can see I have this note area and I can add a lot more text in here. And you can see it actually appears there underneath. And this is great for having a title for a reminder item and then having more information like people's names, phone numbers, and all that in a note rather than just having a very long title. You can also share reminders lists. So for instance, shopping list here, you notice that if I move my cursor over it, there's this symbol that appears. If I click that symbol, I can hit share with and I can enter in the Apple ID for someone else. So I can share, say, the shopping list with my wife. We'll both see this reminders list on our Macs and our iPhones, and we can add and remove items from it. It's very handy to do whether it's in a work situation or for something like this for personal or home use. Now, using this plus button or simply clicking down below the last item and entering text isn't the only way to enter a new item. You can also ask Siri. So first thing I want to do is I want to see what the default list is. I'll go to Reminders Default List and I'll see it's set to to-do. So let's just go to the list named Reminders, which is this one. And now I can use the keys on my keyboard or the Siri button on my Mac to ask Siri to add a new item. Remind me to check my bank balance tomorrow at 10 a.m.
Okay, I'll remind you.
And you can see it added to that reminders list, and there it is, it's set with the time and everything. You can also set up a location reminder instead of or in addition to a time reminder. So you can give it an address from your contacts list, and you can use things like home or work as well. And this works with your iPhone to give you a notification when you're actually at that location. Now there's things that you can do with the lists themselves. You just need to know that you control click on them to do things like control clicking will allow you to rename or delete a list. You can also complete all the reminders in the list at once. And you can also open a list in a new window. So you can have multiple windows open. So this window could be showing my shopping list, and this window is my reminders list. I can bring up my to-do list as well. So you can have as many of these windows as you want. You can see them listed all in here under window at the bottom. And you can always get to the main one by using the keyboard shortcut command 0 to bring that up. You also can drag and drop between lists in this mode. So I can drag the buy bread over to shopping pretty easily. But you can do it without any additional windows as well. So under the reminders list, I could drag buy bread over to shopping just by dragging it over to the left.